In this tutorial, we'll look at the workflow for selecting any one model on the leaderboard and deploying it to a DataRobot prediction server. We'll demonstrate deploying a time series model first in the graphical user interface and then using the DataRobot Python API. This is important because once experimentation is finished and a final model is selected, it must be moved into production. We start on the Models tab for a project where AutoPilot is complete. You'll notice that when AutoPilot completes, there will be one model marked with the green tags that say recommended for deployment and prepared for deployment. Let's accept the suggestion from AutoPilot and deploy the recommended model. Click on the row on the leaderboard to expand and see the details. The Predict menu has submenus for making predictions in the GUI and two options for model portability, which are out of scope for this Getting Started tutorial, but very important to know about. Refer to the documentation to learn more. Today, I'll deploy to a DataRobot prediction server using the automated process available by selecting Predict and then Deploy. There's a lot of text here, but the main decision is whether to add the model to the model registry first or deploy it directly from the leaderboard. Adding to the registry is a best practice for governance, so let's do it that way. Clicking Add to Model Registry creates a new entry in the Model Packages section of the model registry, but your view does not change. Then click on Deploy on the right. Now the view does change, and we're within the Deployment section of DataRobot. There are a few items to fill in. Most of this information can be changed later if you need to change a setting or add or remove a deployment capability. Give the deployment a name. Choose the prediction environment that ends in datarobot.com unless you have other prediction environments already set up. Make a decision about how time will be handled. This cannot be changed later. Set the deployment importance. If configured, each choice will trigger different approval and governance workflows. Review the options under Advanced Options to familiarize yourself with them, but accept all the defaults for now. Finally, check that everything on the right-hand side matches your expectations. When you're ready, click Deploy Model. This will kick off a fully automated process to create the deployment and set up all the ML production capabilities, including API endpoints, monitoring, and lifecycle management. In many organizations, this process can take several weeks. DataRobot completes it in less than a minute for most models. The deployment has now been created. If you need to change any settings for the deployment, you'll find most of them either in the Overview tab or in the Settings tab. Click on Deployments in the main menu to see all the deployments you have access to. When sorted by creation date, your new deployment will be on the top. Now we'll repeat several of those steps in a DataRobot notebook using the Python API. We start at the point where AutoPilot has completed, and this cell retrieves the list of models that have gone through the prepare for deployment process. This could be more than one, so we select the first one from the list and retrieve its model ID. The cell below lists all of the prediction environments that you have access to, and again, selects the first one in case there's more than one. The cell below creates the deployment. We use the function createFromLearningModel. The three arguments tell DataRobot which specific model to deploy to which prediction server and give it a name. This deployment ID can now be used to update any settings and to start scoring new records through this model. You should now be able to deploy a specific time series model to a DataRobot prediction server.